Kyle, are you there?
Yeah, I thought you said not to fight Dasan alone.
I didn't have a choice. I never even felt him coming. He's escaped onto a ship.
I know. I'm on it.
We need to destroy the ship before Dasan and his army reaches its target, whatever it is. Try to find the ship's communication center and use its sensor array to contact Rogue Squadron. I'll keep trying.
Luke!
Force begin.
Alrighty, what's happening? This is Lightning Bolt Forever back again with more Star Wars Jedi Outcast, level 18, Doomgiver's Communications Array. Alright, so yes, we finally made it onto the Doomgiver, and we have a lot to do in this level. We have to search for Jan, find Doomgiver's Communications Array, contact Rogue Squadron using the Communications Array, and set the Doomgiver Sensor Array to Rogue Squadron's communicator frequency with these input codes here. So, yeah, we also have a ton of force upgrades starting this level off. First off is force jump. We're now maxed out here. We can leap up to 12 times our normal height, which is pretty cool. Yes, mind trick is also maxed out. We can distract and befriend enemies for 15 seconds, which is, it'll come in handy in these next few levels. And, yes, force lightning is finally at rank 2. We can maintain the force lightning for a sustained forward attack. And, yes, Saber Defense is now maxed out. We have a larger defense area and can deflect attacks back at the attacker, with increased deflection speed, of course. And, finally, we have the last of the lightsaber styles here, the Strong style. This style allows us to use powerful strikes to batter through defenses, and, great range and power, but often leaves us open to counterattacks, so we do need to be careful in lightsaber duels. But, yeah, this kind of style, because the swings are so much larger in diameter, I guess is the right word, than the fast style, it's not really that useful for fighting, waves of troopers. So, this will come more in handy for duels. But anyway, yeah, it's represented by a red bar down here, and, let's go ahead and get to it. I'm actually not going to use strong style straight away, we're just going to stick with fast. We're going to get out the saber here and head on forward, because we've got a bunch of troopers underneath us on the bridge here. Ooh, nice. Get rid of these guys. Yeah, we're just gonna clean house here with these mugs. Come here. Yeah. But yeah, it's actually pretty crazy. Because we're at, max or rank 3 saber defense, technically, you don't even really have to attack these guys. Kyle will just block all the shots back at the troopers. And it's like that, pretty much from here on out. Chances are you'll end up just killing guys before you even get to them. But anyway, yeah. Let's go ahead and get back up here. And yeah, we've just cleared out the first wave there, and now we will head on down. Right here. Whoop. No, fellas. You know better than that. Whoop. Whoop. There we go. Alright, there we go. Now, I was about to say, now I got them all. Anyway, let's take out the turrets. And this one over here. Alright, and that's all of them. We can grab some shields. Hit this switch here to open up the door into the next area. And this guy never seems to drop his gun, but he's dead now. Hey, get out of here. Yeah. I think that is everyone, unless one of them... Oh! There. Whoop. Didn't have enough force... I was trying to use saber throw there, but I didn't have enough force energy. But anyway, with that key, we can now go in here, pick up some ammo that we... any ammo that we need. Now, the strong style. Here's the pose for it. As you can see, here's fast, here's medium, and here is strong. And as you can see, it's very calculated, drawn-out swings there. Very slow swings. But they do incredible damage. And it's very useful against Reborn, like what we're about to face right here. So let's wind her on up. Whoop. Oh, jeez. Yeah, just like that. I mean, you can even get this guy in just one swing, too. But the thing is that you want to wind it up and then move in for the kill, because, like the description said, you'll leave yourself open to attack. But, anyway, yeah. Actually, we'll keep using it for this next part here. We'll take this elevator down.
What was that?
Ah! Just like that. All right, and we'll grab his supply key. And, yeah, when we get into this room, down that way, that door is locked. And these two doors are unlocked because the lights are turned off. So we're going to go through the one on the right first. Break the grate up here and switch the flechette and jump up through here. This is on the way to secret number one. We go ahead, go! Oh, jeez. I'm hit, boys, I'm hit! Yeah. Alright, Kyle, that's enough. Come on. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Come on, there we go. Anyway, yeah. That can be particularly nasty there, and I'm gonna wait on picking up that shield booster, because I don't really need it right now. But yeah, that's secret number one down there. And, well, yeah, that's what happens when you get hit by a torture droid, too. So, yeah, this door is locked, so what we're gonna do is just jump straight across. Break the grate up there. I'll go ahead and collect some ammo here. And let's not have a repeat of what just happened here. We got lots more torture droids in this area. Okay, there we go. There's one here. And let's see. I think we've got more down this way. If you follow this path down, the left path, it'll actually take you to a storage box that we can't open yet. So we're going to come back to this little area. We want to go right here. Break the grate. Give up, rebel. Oop. There. Swing at this guy. And, yeah, with his supply key... Well, yeah, we can open the door there. But more importantly, with his supply key, we can run back into here and pick up whatever was in that box, which I think it's just a training remote. Or training remote. Secret drone there, not training remotes. But, yeah, that's what's in there. So, yeah. Yeah, we'll go ahead and head on back over that way. And we'll drop down. All right, and right here, now that we've got the door open, hit the computer here.
Let's see how good I am as an R5.
All right, and yeah, we take control of an R5 unit. So, yeah, with this little guy, we want to... Oh, yes, head out this way. And we need to unlock the doors that were locked behind these two doors here. Actually, really, you only need to open one of them. And I am I'm just going to go to the right, just because. And if you do it this way, you can see that, we need to hit that switch back there, but this guy's standing in the way. So let's head on over here and distract him. You can open up this little door for a sentry turret. But yeah, this guy will come walking this way, and now we can open up this door. Yeah, and the stormtroopers are going to catch on that something isn't quite right here. But, yeah, all you have to do is just retreat back to the room you started in and switch on back to Kyle, and we can go through that door. And, yeah, like I said, it really, it doesn't really matter which, door you... It doesn't really matter which door you take. But, yeah. I think there's the same... I think there's, like, the same number of troopers on both sides. So, yeah, in the end, it doesn't really... matter, but anyway, yeah, once you get rid of everybody, you can take the elevator down, and this should take us to, yes, this little room here with an ammo dispenser, which I'm going to wait on getting. I'm actually going to use the crossbow here. Now in this room, yes, shoot that turret first, and I'll switch to the demp 2 to get that little bugger up there. Did I get him? Yeah, I got him. Yeah, we have that little guy up there. That was the Mark II assault droid. And, at least I think that's what he's called. But yeah, these guys, they'll do pretty good amount of damage to you, so be careful for them. Luckily, though, I think this is the only level they appear in. But we got this droid here. And that turret up there. All right. That's the end of him, so let's get the saber back out, fill up on ammo. Nice. We'll go ahead and heal up, why not? And, yeah, when we get up here, what the heck? I was gonna pick that power cell up and it just vanished. But anyway, yeah, we need to get into this control room here, but the doors leading into there are locked. So, we're obviously going to have to go another way, and, yeah... If you decided to take the other elevator down or open the other door back where all the R5s were, then yeah, you would have been brought to a shield dispenser, but you end up in the same area anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Anyway, we're going to go this way now, and secret number two is right in here with some shield boosters and some more detonation packs. Yeah, we haven't had detonation packs for a while. But anyway, break the glass here. And let's see. Yeah, just a nice nice saber throw there to get rid of all the torture droids. And we will take the elevator up. Hey! Hey, it's for horses. Come here. Nice. Got them down, got him down, got him, and this guy. Alright, so they're all dead. Let's pick up whatever ammo we may need. I'll wait on those shields.
Looks like they use a tram system to get around. This must be one big ship.
Yeah, it was hard to hear there, but Kyle said, looks like they're using a tram system to get around. This must be one big ship. So you can hit all four of these switches to call all four trams, and, actually, yeah, I'm gonna grab that last shield booster real quick. So yeah, we, in the end, we'll only end up taking one tram, but, yeah. When you unlock the doors to get out of here, you honestly don't even have to fight these stormtroopers. I just like to run for it, and pretty much just hold them off and head down these stairs here until the tram gets here. And then hit the switch, and you're off. Yeah, this part of the level's pretty cool. This is probably my favorite part. Just being able to ride the tram, but we only do it once, though. And taking one of the lower trams is, it actually sets you at a good vantage point for this, this next area here. Right here. So as soon as this opens up, yes, we can go up the stairs and see if you took one of the upper level trams. As you can see by that door on the left, you would have been set in the middle of all of these guys. Where are you going? You die. But yeah, Kyle will just block all the shots here. Come here. Whoa. Yeah, I mean, you could use speed to take these guys out real quickly, but you really don't even need to because of the freaking, just of how many shots Kyle's able to block at a time. Ooh, nice. All right, and I think there's more turrets over this way. There sure are. And then this one, yeah, there we go. Nice upper lunge attack there. Power cells, and yeah, we should be good. Let's go through here. So yeah, when we get in here, yeah, there's going to be a whole bunch of guys and a turret, and I just like to stand here and let Kyle block all these shots here, because, yeah, look at him go. Look at him go. Right back to the troopers there. Come here. The other one. There we go. And there should be two more around back here, like that. Oh, you don't even need to... Oh, wait, never mind. I was going to say something, but, yeah, never mind. I was going to say that you don't really need to go forward when you're doing the attack, but obviously you do for it to work, but, yeah, whatever. Anyway, yeah, we have found the communications array, but if we try to use it...
It's offline,
so we have to set it all up here. So let's go through. Yeah, it doesn't matter which door you take. We'll just go through this one here. And knock these guys down. And you, sir. Yeah, you die. So anyway, yeah. In this room, we have these control panels here. And yeah, notice that this one's going crazy.
It's offline.
Yeah, we need to reconfigure these control panels so that they will function properly. So the way we do that is head down here. And, ooh, check this out.
The whole thing's set up like some kind of code.
Yeah, so what we have to do here is this is where we have to set up all of our, all the input codes here. So I actually like to, yeah, we have to set the red, the green, and the blue. And I actually like to work my way from the bottom and, well, start from the bottom and work my way up here. So, yeah, to get to the blue one, I just like to jump down to here, then jump across, turn to the right, jump across, and let's see. Jump here. Oh, no, no, no. There we go. I was about to say there should be a bridge down here somewhere. And head down here. There we go. Now, this is the first one we need to hit, and you can tell this is the right one because of the little foot sticking out right there of this little building here. But just carefully, ever so slightly, inch your way off, and hit this one. And so, yes, we have the blue triangle out of the way. Now, Let's jump back up. And the final secret of the level is around back here. Just carefully drop down onto the platform, and you can grab a seeker drone, detonation packs, and a back to tank. And we need to get back up, so let's jump on up here. Alright. Now, the green one, which is the next level up, we need to jump across again, and turn to the left, and it's up there. So this is probably the trickiest one to get to. Jump up on in here. The three horizontal lines, as you can see there. And, getting out of here is the trickiest part. Jump right when you get out. And now for the red one, we'll jump across here. Yeah, there's more in these other rooms here, but I just want to hit these things and head on out of here. And this one right here with the arrow pointing down. So yes, that is all the clearance codes, or input codes, whatever they are. And now we need to get back out of here. So let's actually jump down and jump up again. Right there. Hit the switch. And we are good to go. Alright. So you can just force jump right up on out of here. Yeah, you can. Alright. So, now what we can do is go inside each of these little hubs here and activate the switches to set the frequency straight. Head around this way here. Blue triangle. We got the red arrow already. And, yes, the three green lines here are the last ones we have to do.
That should do it. Come on, Rogues. I hope you're listening.
Alright. So we have, we've set up the frequency, and now we need to contact Rogue Squadron. So let's go through this door. Oh, we got some troopers in here. Nice. You die. He's dead. And one more guy. Bye-bye. Alright. So that's the end of all them. And, it's now time to talk to Rogue Squadron.
Leader, Katarn. Rogue Leader to Kyle Katarn.
Rogue Leader, this is Kyle Katarn.
Katarn, good to hear your voice. We've locked onto your signal and are in pursuit. That is one whale down of a ship you've hooked, Kyle.
Can you bring her down?
Maybe, but I'd feel a lot better about our chances if somebody on the inside were working to disable the ship's shield array.
I'll see what I can do about those shields, but I've got some unfinished business here.
Understood. Once you get the shields down, make sure you get out of there in a hurry, because there's not going to be much left of this ship once we're done with her.
Don't waste any time on my account.
Good luck, Kyle. Rogue Leader out.
Got it. Been on the way to the shields, too.
Alright.
All crew members, prepare to drop out of hyperspace.
Alright, so here we go. The Doomgiver has left hyperspace. And I always love this cutscene right here. Because then out of nowhere, as you'll soon see in a second here... Here come the rebels! Alright. they just come flying on in and, the battle ensues. Yeah, get them all.
Great.
Okay, and so with that, all that's left to do now is to find Jan. So let's head through that door that Kyle unlocked just a second ago. Yeah, we're pretty much done with this level. All we have to do is not go in there. We need to head down this way and up the stairs here and through this door and down this hallway is our exit. Alright, so we have completed the first of the Doomgiver levels, and there's only three Doomgiver levels, which is, honestly, I'm pretty thankful that there's only three of these levels instead of four, because, especially after coming off the Karen installation, there's a lot of, this is kind of the point in the game where the levels start to look a little repetitive just because of all the, the cargo ship, all the gray monotone colors being used here. But we got all three secrets, and when we come back, I will see you in level 19, the Doomgiver's detention facility. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll catch you later. All right, so this is just a little something I wanted to throw in right at the end here. So it turns out there's actually a pretty cool Easter egg in this level. And, well, yeah, to get to it, we're going to bring up the console and enable cheats here. And we'll say no clip like that. And, yeah, it turns out if you clip through the Doomgiver and through space, pretty much, you come right up above here and check it out. It's Earth. Yeah, Earth in Jedi Outcast. This is actually, I don't know, it's pretty crazy that this is here. It's, I don't know, it's very random. But anyway, yeah, I thought that was pretty cool. But yeah, I'm not sure what's going on over there. But yes, this begs the question, does Star Wars really take place in a galaxy far, far away? But anyway, yeah, planet Earth right here in Jedi Outcast. That's pretty much all I wanted to show off. So yeah, see you in the next episode.